guy who could treat me right. Hey, oh, hey, oh, oh. Why take a chance, will you let me ride? Hey, oh, hey, oh, oh. I could be the best thing in your life.皆さん、ヒーゼルです。今回の動画では私が日本語を取得するとき使ってる6つのポイントを紹介していきたいと思います。残念ながらネイティブレベルそういう感じでないんですけれども、でもやっぱりコミュニケーションがとっても大事ですね。だから私が毎日一生懸命勉強してるが、少しずつ日本語を覚えました。もうご存知かもしれませんが、私がフィリピンのマリスダッチで、タガルグと英語が話せます。去年ですね、2月、コロナの前に日本に初めて来て、その時全然日本語を話せませんでした。もうなかなか日本語が難しいと思いますね。でもこの6つのポイントが私の中では素敵な勉強方法を紹介するので、ぜひ行ってください。そういうのが、そういうの aking Japanese。Pwede na kaya? Woo! Yan, ganun, pag nag-Japanese ako. Pero ayun, ano, medyo balik muna tayo sa Tagalog. And may English subtitle naman yan sa baba. And gusto ko lang magpasalamat kay Ate Mary Grace, ayan, for requesting this video. Kay Ate Lani, Josa Nuite, Ann Mazo Gamol, Judy May Gamol, Vanessa Ariola, kay Carlo, Dada, and Jejomar for always commenting on my video. And sa inyo, sa mga nanonood nito, talagang sumusuporta kahit sobrang newbie pa lang ako. Wala pa ako masyadong alam talaga sa pagbablogging. And ayun, if bago kayo sa channel na to, baka naman, baka mapindot nyo na rin yung subscribe button dyan sa bandang baba. And anyway, ayun lang naman. And see you on the next video. Tapos. And ayun, para ito sa mga newbie or beginner na interesado matuto mag-Japanese. And anyway, disclaimer lang. Ako language guru ah. Language guru ba yung tawag doon? Pero, ayun, basta hindi ako professional sa gantong bagay. Ito ay based lang. I-share ko ay based lang sa personal experience ko. And nag-work naman siya. So, sana makatulong din sa inyo kahit papano. And wala nang MMM, simulan na natin to. For beginners, I suggest you start learning Japanese through their writing system. Now let's start with katakana. Katakana is one of the Japanese alphabets and used for writing foreign names. Now you may find it confusing because there are characters looks like similar or almost the same. That's why I use this method to easily memorize those 46 basic katakana characters. Mnemonics. Well, Google says that it's such a pattern to help or assist you in remembering something. To give you an example, these two characters looks like the same, right? But the first character reads as she in Japanese. And to easily recognize the character she from tsu, let's try to use mnemonics. Since katakana she looks like smiling face, I use the picture of the girl smiling. As how you read the character she, so she is smiling. And for tsu, since it looks like wave, I use the picture of the man enjoying surfing. And that's how to use mnemonic. Well, most of the time I draw, or it depends on you on how you'll create your own mnemonic or technique to easily recognize those basic characters. Okay, so now let's move on to hiragana. It's another part of Japanese writing system. Well, the only tip that I can give you, which really works for me as well, is to practice Japanese songs in karaoke. Well, it doesn't matter if you are not good in singing, but the idea of practicing or reading hiragana on every lyrics that moving on your screen, you can memorize it, how it looks like, or how to read each of those hiragana characters. After you memorized katakana and hiragana, you must need to learn kanji. But kanji is more complicated rather than the two because there are thousands of kanji characters. And my tip for beginners, try 5 kanji per day for the first few weeks, and when you became comfortable learning it, try 10 kanji and so on. Now here's the thing, there's a huge possibility that you might easily forget them. And the only way is consistency, and do not memorize it, but learn how to read each specific character instead.
Now, my third tip for you is watching Japanese movies, drama, and animes. During your first few months, use English subtitle, but if you already memorized katakana and hiragana, challenge to use them as a subtitle. Watching Japanese movies really improves your pronunciation and Japanese accent. If you have spare time, you can also watch or follow some content creator on TikTok which upload Japanese language learning.
Ohayo! Ohayo gozaimasu!
Ai, mai, mi, mai! Watashi! Watashi no! Watashi ni! Watashi no mono!
Fourth, set your daily schedule and follow. 15 to 30 minutes will be fine if you always have busy schedule. Fifth point, read, write, listen, repeat. As I've said, consistency is the key. Even just few minutes you spend to learn one phrase for day, that's equivalent to 30 phrases for month that can help you survive at least the commute from one station to another or maybe ordering food from fast food chain. Anyway, here's I show you the only app that I am using until now. It's a 7-day free trial, but if you don't have a budget yet for premium, you can create a spare account to access. This is not sponsored, but what I like about this app, it has 5 levels and you can start from absolute beginner. It has vocabulary list, which you can create your own word bank as well. It has lesson notes, which highlights the most important words you need to learn from the conversation. It also has lesson transcript that you can read while listening to the podcast. And to access the podcast of this lesson, just click Audio 1 to listen.
Word meaning Risa. Person's first name.
Risa. Risa.
Last is the word meaning M.
です。リサです。はじめまして、リサです。
Now, if you finished the lesson, just click Mark Complete so you will remember what lesson you need to study next time. Listening podcast while you are driving, eating, or even stuck on the heavy traffic can give you a lot of new vocabularies. As of now, I'm focusing on learning to read and write kanji. This textbook, which is for elementary grade, consists of basic kanji that you have to learn, kanji that you can see anywhere. In short, mastering this textbook can help you to survive everyday living in Japan. Learning basics is fine for me because here's the trivia. Not all Japanese can read kanji. Yes. There is someone or a lot of them cannot read complicated kanji as well, so don't be stressed. Lastly, and I guess the most important, practice by speaking together with the native speakers. Don't be shy, go out and order something on restaurants. Interact with Japanese. Enroll online class with sensei. Practice to create your own paragraph and read it aloud. And that's my 6 tips for you. I hope you learned something from it. Thank you for watching, minasang. And always remember, when you are struggling learning Japanese right now, I know you can do it, especially when you do it with purpose. Hai, minasang, gambatte kudasai. Ja, mata ne!